If you're a traditional artist, your instinct might be to start your work using carefully drawn line art. While sticking to what you know might be comfortable, it's not necessarily the best workflow for pixel art. When creating digital art, you can take a completely different approach. Using the basic brush tool set to a fairly large size, you can sketch the form indirectly to quickly work out the overall size, proportions, positions, and general color scheme all at the same time. Drastic changes are painless because no real time or effort was used to achieve a foundation to work with. Just use the right mouse button to erase and the left to draw to refine the silhouette. Using freehand brush scaling works great as you do not have to worry about a line drawing becoming very distorted. It's often very useful to use ProMotionNG's layer support to simultaneously block in an entire game mockup all at once, switching back and forth between the layers to iterate on and refine the game's entire visual style simultaneously. Once you've finished an environment image, using it as a locked background layer to create sprite art on top of really helps you make sure the final image will work well in its intended visual environment. Now that our character is blocked in, we'll be making extensive use of ProMotion's awesome multi-shade mode to simultaneously add detail and shading. But before we cover the benefits of the multi-shade feature, let's quickly cover the other available shading and tinting options. If you choose Mode, Brightness, or press the F3 key and left click and drag, you'll see that ProMotion is brightening any pixels you paint over. If you right click and drag, you're darkening the pixels. The severity of the effect can be set by adjusting the percentile here near the top left of ProMotion's window. If you choose Mode, Tint, or press the F5 key and left click and drag, you'll see that ProMotion will change the color hue of the pixels you paint over to match whichever color you currently have selected. Right clicking and dragging will have the same effect, but based on whatever background color you've selected in the palette using the right mouse button. Now if you choose Mode, Translucent, or press Shift and F1 and left click and drag, you'll see the currently selected color is painted over the artwork as though it's translucent to whatever percentile you set. It's very important to know that with all these modes I mentioned, ProMotion can only choose from the colors that are in the color palette to create these shading or tinting effects, so the quality of outcome depends greatly on what colors are available in the 256 color indices. While this automatic use of any color from any index in the palette often might not matter, traditional pixel art for classic video games required much more careful control of which color indices are used for any particular image, tile, or game sprite. This is where ProMotion's fantastic multi-shade feature comes in. The first thing to do is make sure your palette is arranged in a compliant manner to whatever limitations you need to work with, or at least in sensible gradients providing the colors your art will need. The next thing to do is choose Color, Gradients, or press the Q key to bring up the Gradients dialog. Now click the Add button, name your new gradient, and click the Define Colors button. A new dialog will appear which lets you pick specific colors from the palette. Left-clicking will select them, and right-clicking will deselect them. Once you've selected all the colors you want in the gradient, click the Add button and you'll see they now populate the gradient in the gradient dialog. Left-clicking and dragging on any color lets you shift its position in the gradient relative to the other colors. Once the colors are arranged in the order you desire, click the checkbox to turn on the option Enable for Multi-Shade Paint Mode and click OK. Use these same steps to create as many additional gradients as you need. Once your gradients are set up and are enabled for use with multi-shade, close the gradients dialog and choose Mode Multi-Shade or press Ctrl+Alt+F9 and start to paint over your image with the left or right mouse button. You'll see that the left mouse button will replace any background pixel which is part of any of the gradients with the next color in that particular gradient. The right mouse button will replace the background pixel with the previous color in the gradient. This can allow you to add shading and details to your blocked-in image incredibly quickly, and with no need to frequently click in the color palette for the particular color you're after. It's very important to keep in mind if you use the same color indices in multiple gradients, and they are all enabled for multi-shade mode, then you could get undesired results. The best way around this is to either not reuse the same color indices in multiple gradients or to disable the multi-shade option for the gradient you do not want to use at that particular moment. The most common time this shared color occurs is with white and black, as they tend to be on either end of many gradients. and it would be a terrible waste in a 16-color sprite palette to have to duplicate black and white colors for each gradient the sprite will use. Here are the two best ways we can work around this problem. The first is to have a separate white and black for each gradient, but once the art is done, alter the palette to remove the extra white and black indices and remap the images so all black and white pixels are using the same respective indices. The second option is to simply save the brightest white highlights and darkest black shadows for the final touches of the art, and do it manually without using the multi-shade mode, so you can use the single white and black index for the highlights and shadows of all the gradients. Thanks for watching.